Hey y'all, it's your girl Javiah from Gifted Hands by Javiah. Welcome back to another video. If this is your first time tuning in, hey y'all, hey, welcome. If you are already a part of the Gifted family, welcome back fam, welcome back. Y'all, in today's video, I'm going to show you how to make the cutest custom trick-or-treat bag for Halloween using none other than dye sublimation, of course. Y'all, Halloween is right around the corner. Spooky season is amongst us, so you already know I gotta come and show y'all what we gonna be making for this upcoming Halloween season. The very first project I'm gonna show you is these custom trick-or-treat bags, okay? And look at how cute this is, y'all. This is the bag that I'm going to show you how to make today, okay? These bags are 100% polyester bags. They are actually shopping bags. These are non-woven, okay? So not only am I going to show you how to make this, okay, I'm going to show you how to add a little bit of oomph to these bags by adding some lights. Ah! Yeah, this is gonna be so cute. Just imagine when it's dark outside or if you are in a darker room or area, like look at this, okay? So these are double-sided as well. And I absolutely love them. You won't be able to fully get the effect here because my room is very much bright. So let me go into another room where it's darker and I can show you how this looks.
Spooky. Y'all get this? Get into that. Yes.
Now that y'all got a chance to see what this looks like in the dark, who's ready for this video? This project is so easy. It is very simple. It is not as complex as it may look. And I'm going to show you step by step on how to make this. Now today I am going to be using my Epson Sure Color F570 dye sublimation printer. And I'll be sure to leave everything I use down below in the description for you in case you are interested in making these yourself. I already know that y'all are. So be sure to check out the description, y'all, okay? I'm also going to go over the supplies that we're going to need, and then we're going to get started with the video. So let me stop talking, okay? I know y'all ready to get started, so we're going to get started, all right? If this is something that you're interested in learning, please stick around. Stay tuned. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe to my channel. Turn on the bell for notifications so that you can be notified every time your girl uploads a new video. So, without further ado, let's go.
Alright y'all, so let's get into the supplies and the materials that we're going to need for today's project. So I have some Scotch tape, I have some balloon glue dots, I purchased these off of Amazon, I have some fairy lights, also purchased these from off of Amazon, and y'all, again, I'll be sure to leave everything linked down below in my description. I have a pair of scissors, my handy dandy measuring tape, I have my 100% polyester reusable shopping bag. It is double-sided, okay? And I have some butcher paper. My design is currently being printed right now, so you are going to need your design. And I am going to be using my 16x20 Stahl Tytronics Autoclamp heat press for this project today. However, you can use an easy press, okay? But I will be using the heat press today. And y'all, that is it. That is it for all of, for the supplies and the materials, all right? So, let's get started. All right, y'all. So, I'm going to show you how to measure the shopping bag. I honestly already measured the bag, but for the sake of this tutorial, I'm going to show you how I measure it, okay? So, I'm going to take my handy dandy measuring tape, and I'm going to start off with the width. And my width is about 15 inches. And then my height is about 15.35 inches. When you are creating your design, if you are going to be doing a full bleed graphic design for your bag, right? You want to make your design slightly larger than the actual substrate itself than the actual bag, okay? So you want to make it at least 0.25 inches larger, okay? Also, my trick-or-treat bag is going to be a full graphic design on the front and on the back, which is why I'm using my 24 inch dye sublimation printer. If you do not have a large format printer, meaning a printer that allows you to print in one go, like the 24 inch short color F570, you will have to tile or slice and then piece together your image if you want to do a full graphic design, okay? And if you do not have that large format printer. If you do not want a full bleed design, you can measure where you want your design to be and then proceed as necessary, okay? Another option that you can do is you can sublimate the handles if you want to, okay? So if you are a seamstress or if you know how to sew or if you wanna remove the seams here, sublimate the handles and then sew it back or glue it back, you can do that as well, okay? So that is another option for you. I'm not doing that. I'm just going to focus on the actual body of the bag itself. So let's go ahead and get our design from the printer. All right, y'all, I'm gonna just take that out. And here is our Wednesday design. Ready to go. So let's go to our heat press and press this design on up. Lego. All right, y'all, so here I am at my heat press. I have my heat press set at 400 degrees and we are going to be pressing the design onto the tote bag for 60 seconds. First, I am going to pre-press the bag to get any wrinkles out. I'm going to pre-press it for about 5 seconds. This is butcher paper. All right, that should be good. Now we are going to take our design, align our bag up with the design, and then tape it down with some heat-resistant tape. Now, this would have been better if I would have done this on, like, at my table, but this is okay. So all I'm doing is just aligning my bag looks good. I'm going to go in and add some heat resistant tape. I am using my handy dandy clear heat resistant tape. And as always, y'all, I'm going to leave everything I use in this video down below in the description box. All right. So I'm going to tape up here and I'm going to use 4 pieces of tape. Pieces of tape. Some more right here. And then also right here. What I'm also going to do is just add a little piece of tape right here so that the ink do not get on my handles, okay? Because remember, we made our design slightly larger than the actual substrate. So some of the ink is going to get on the handles and I don't want that. I mean, it wouldn't be a huge deal, but I don't really want that. So I'm just going to just put some tape right there. We only need a little bit. Good to go. So now going to take some butcher paper, place it on the bottom of my heat press to protect the bottom from any ink fallout. And then I'm going to take my design and my bag, make sure that I have it nice on my heat press. I actually want to get the handle just a little bit off of the press. Now we are going to press this 400 degrees for 60 seconds with medium pressure. All right, y'all. So now we are going to lift this up. Woo, and that smoke. Okay, so you guys ready for the reveal? Some black fabric marker to color that in, and now I'm going to do the back side. All right, y'all, so I'm going to go ahead and do the back side. So clean butcher paper we need.
I don't know what happened to the other side, how I missed that whole white spot. That's crazy. All right, so we got a clean piece of butcher paper. Align the design up again, and this time I'm going to trim off the white around the design just to make the pressing a little bit more easier. So let me go ahead and do that real quick. Okay, y'all, so now I'm just going to go ahead and line this up. Hopefully I align it good this time. I made this design larger than my bag, like I always do, y'all. But that's okay. Thank goodness the base of the design is black, because I can go in with a black fabric marker. Let me see. Actually, I don't have a black fabric marker, but I do have a black permanent marker. So I'm just going to go in and fill that white area in with a permanent black marker. And we should be good to go. So now I'm just going to go ahead and tape this down. And I'm going to speed past this part because it's literally the same process that I just did. I'm going to tape it and then press it. All right, y'all, so we're gonna check out the back sides. And it's looking good, so let's see, y'all ready? Fill and reveal. Oh yeah, yes sir, yes sir. This one did really, really, really well. Yes. Look at how cute, y'all. Ew.
Yes, minus my little mess up right here. I know what happened. I figured it out. Because this is 15 inches in width and my heat press is 16 inches, I don't think I had this bottom part on my heat press all the way, okay? And I couldn't really tell either because my butcher paper was blocking, but that's all right. But this side came out really, really nice. Do y'all see that? Yes. Okay. And then also right here where the tape is, let me see if y'all can see. Okay. So you see that little bit of ink right there? That would have been on my handle and I didn't want that. So because I think I'm going to paint the handles, maybe a purple color to go with this bag. But this is so fire. All right, y'all. So what we're going to do now is I'm going to color this in. I'm going to show y'all that part. And then we're going to go ahead and add in the fairy lights. All right, let's go. All right, y'all. So here is my bag. Let me just show you guys again where I messed up at. You see that white? Everything else looks really, really good. The colors are vibrant. I am loving this. All right. So now what I'm going to do is just color in this white space with a black permanent marker. I don't have any fabric marker, so permanent marker it is for me. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put something in the inside. I think I'm going to put a little piece of parchment paper on the inside just so that it doesn't bleed through onto the other side. And then I'm just going to go in with the fabric marker and paint along. Not paint, but color in along the white edge there. All right, y'all, so we colored it in and that's what it looks like. Okay, can't even tell. Okay, so now take this out. We are going to put in our fairy lights. All right, so the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to turn this inside out because I do think that it's easier to turn the bag inside out so that we can see where to place our balloon glue dots and our fairy lights. So I'm just going to go ahead and turn this inside out. Okay. Trying to make sure I keep y'all in the camera so that y'all can see. If I was a singer, man, nobody can tell me I'm not Whitney Houston when I'm in the shower. Cause I can blow when I'm in the shower. Okay. That note be high too. Call me Whitney. Call me Whitney. Okay. So enough of my little storytelling. So now that we got this inside out, I'm going to pay attention to where my tag is, okay, because that's our back. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to get the glue dots as close to the seam as possible. Okay, I want it to be really close to the seam as possible. Okay, so actually, y'all, the tab is on this side, so this is our front, okay? The seams are going to fold forward. So that's how you know which side is which, okay? So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my glue dots and I am going to put glue dots along this edge, okay? And this edge. So we're gonna do a square. And then I'm only going to put glue dots on the back side across the top, okay? So I'm going to speed this part up. Actually, I'll show y'all real quick. So right here, I'm going to start with my glue dot right here, right at the top. And then I am going to go down the edge of the bag, and my goal is to get it, like I said, very close to the edge, okay? And if it's not close to the edge, it's okay. Close enough will work. All right, just like that. Okay, and then here I'm just going to cut it, grab a pair of scissors to make it easier. All right, so now I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing. If your glue dot messed up like that, cut that off, because our goal is to have them nice and flat on our bags. So I'm just going to go ahead and do the same thing. bit lower. I want to get it to the bottom, as close to the bottom as possible. Okay, y'all? Close to the bottom as possible and close to the seam as possible.
Just like so.
And then I'm just going to go ahead and do the same thing for the other sides, okay? All right, y'all. So now that we have applied our glue dots along the edges of our bag, I'm just going to go in with my finger and burnish it down real good because we want to make sure that the glue dots are nice and flat. We don't want any messed up glue dots, okay? And I know over here I gotta add a glue dot because it got messed up over on that side, but that's okay. I can just go in and add a glue dot
one, but for the most part we looking good.
Okay, and now I'm just going to go ahead and peel away the white backing carefully to expose the glue dots. Okay, so again, you see how that got a little funky, but that's okay. We want to make sure that they are flat. Okay, so that's why, you know, you just be real careful, you burnish it down real good, and your glue dots will be nice and flat. So I want to go ahead and continue to do this along the rest of the bags. All right, y'all, so this is what it should be looking like so far with the glue dots, okay? Now, I do wanna add a glue dot right here at the corner, like towards the very, very, very edge, okay? So that's what I'm going to do real quick. I just need one right here and then one right here. So I'm gonna take a glue dot and place one right here at the very edge. Burnish that down, peel. Like so, and then I'm going to do the same for the other side. Y'all, these glue dots are very, 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 very sticky. They hold very well. Burnish that down. Okay, good. I didn't peel the back side yet, but we're gonna get there, okay? So now, we are going to take our fairy lights, okay? And I'm going to unravel it real quick. And these are 7 feet long, so they fit perfectly around this entire bag. So I was so happy about that part. So we rarely have to double anything, rarely. Once I get this little one out, we should be good to go. Okay, good. And do I have something here? Just stretch that out. Okay, good. So we're good to go. Good to go. So now it's trying to stick. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the very edge of my fairy light and I'm going to apply it right at the very top of my bag. Okay, so I'm gonna stand up because right now I'm sitting down. I'm gonna stand up to do this, and I hope that y'all are gonna be able to catch it in the camera. So all I'm doing, y'all, is I'm taking the fairy light and I'm applying it right on that glue dot at the very edge. And then I'm just going to press while stretching the fairy light down along the glue dots. Okay? Just like this. Okay? So it should look like that. Okay? Now, I'm going to do the same thing along the bottom. So I'm just going to hold it down right there, curve it over, and apply it. Whoops, my fingers getting stuck. The glue dots are so strong, my fingers are getting stuck. Okay? So you want to apply it right on the glue dots. just like this, okay? And apply a little bit of pressure. Do the same thing for this side. Once we get to the edge here, we are going to take the top part and place it right on top of our starting point, just like this, okay? So this is what we should be looking like so far, a rectangle, okay? Now I'm going to flip this over, and we still have this piece, okay? So this piece is the piece that's on top of the starting point, all right? And I'm actually going to put another piece of glue dot there just for extra security so that it can stick. Okay, so right here, I'm going to put another piece of glue dot. All right, y'all, sorry. My camera got a little too hot and I had to allow it to cool down. Okay, so I believe I was talking about adding the glue dot right here at the edge. So burnish that down and then peel away so that we can stick this part nicely right there. I also turned on my ring light too to get a little bit more light in here. It is very gloomy outside today, okay? And I'm just going to just, you know, go in and reinforce those wires of the fairy lights. You know, actually want to get them a little bit more closer towards the edge, like so. And these balloon glue dots are, like I said earlier, they are very sticky, y'all. So you can, if you want, go in and reinforce them with some hot glue if you want. It's really not necessary because these things are holding up very, very well on its own. But if you want, you can definitely go in and reinforce them, the wires, with some hot glue. We're going to reinforce them even more with some tape at the end. So now that we put our glue dot here at the edge, we're going to flip it over and peel this part. Okay, remember, because we have put some glue dots on the top of the back of the bag. And y'all be very careful, because when you flip it over, remember, it's the glue dots are sticky. So I'm actually going to put down this parchment paper so it won't have so much stick to my table. And then now I'm just going to just peel this away. Just like so. Okay. And now I'm going to take this piece, okay, and we're just going to wrap it around. Just wrapping this wire around, applying pressure. Just like this. Okay. Then we're going to flip this back over and then apply that wire along this side just a little bit and then bring it back up. So you're going to do like a doop doop down up, okay? You're going to do down and then you're going to do up, okay? And now I'm just going to go in with some glue dots. So let me show you guys up close and personal. All I did was zigzag it upwards, down and then up. Okay, you want to have the battery out a little bit, because when we have the battery, we don't want to have too much of the wire exposed. And I'll show y'all what I mean, and you know, once we get towards the end. Okay, so now guys, this is what we are looking like so far. Okay, we got our wires all wrapped around and we are good to go. Now, this is sticky. I told you these glue dots are sticky and they are double-sided, so we are not done. We have to apply something over the glue dot so that when we flip it inside out, nothing will get sticky and none of our wires will come out, right? So I'm just going to use some handy dandy Scotch tape. And this part is very, very simple as well. I'm just going to apply the tape right on top of the wire. So I'm going to measure it out real quick. See? Take my scissor. Cut that piece. And then right here, I'm going to start at the top. And literally, whoops. Oh no, come on, tape. I'm just gonna go down right on top of the wire and right on top of the balloon dot. Okay, this is going to give it a nice clean look as well, and it's also going to keep everything nice and secured and in place, especially when we have to flip everything around. So I'm just gonna cut off there at the edge, trim off at the edge any excess tape. Okay, and then I'm just going to go ahead and do the same thing around the remaining edges and also on the back side. All right, y'all, so we finished taping and your bag should look something like this. Okay, remember it is still inside out, and the applying the Scotch tape on top of the wires with the sticky balloon tape is perfect because it's bonding very nicely and securely to the wire and to the balloon dot. Okay, so we want that. We want that nice security going on there. Okay, so now what we're going to do is flip the bag inside out. And I'm just going to be, you know, just be gentle. Start like this. Push my finger down. Like this, like that. See if I can get a good grip to pull it through. And if it wrinkles, you know, which is bound to wrinkle because we're like doing all of this manipulating of the bag, right? That is okay. You can go in with an iron, or if you have a handheld press or an easy press, mini press, you can go in and iron it out if you want. You know what I'm saying? If you want everything to be nice and crisp, flat, non-wrinkled, you can go ahead and iron that out. I wouldn't suggest putting this back under the heat press with the fairy lights. Okay, so yeah, I'm just trying to get this little corner here. Come on now. Okay, actually, y'all, I'm going to just see if I could, there we go, like this. And you could put like a little glue dot here as well, like to keep this in place. You could put a little glue dot. So now what I'm going to do is I am going to click turn on. You see where it says on? So I'm going to do on, and then this little clear piece right here, ooh, my nails is atrocious, I'm going to take that out. Now, you guys, we have our lighted bag. Look at how cute that is, you guys. Let's see what it looks like with the lights turned off.
Alright y'all, here is the finished product. I absolutely love it. I do want to kindly advise, if you are going to sell this to customers, I will highly recommend purchasing some fabric and hot gluing the fabric on top of the fairy light wires. You want to ensure that you are giving your customers a clean, you know, product, high quality product. So, you know, covering those wires will be perfect. Also, you can use heat and bond, or if you sew, you can probably sew a piece of fabric. These are going to be for my children, so the tape is perfectly fine. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing, and thanks for watching. Until next time, later fam.